Everyone, in this video we're going to show you Buna roast or Buna meat. Now we already chopped some onions. We put in a pan with oil there. We put some cardamom here, a couple of cloves of cardamom, a couple of sticks of cinnamon here, some bay leaves, and chopped onion, garlic and ginger all grind together. Garlic and ginger, obviously we grind them down there. Is a little feta, ginger grind up, clove of garlic grind, yeah, shredded, not shredded, couple of chopped onions, and we just simmer in away, and there is the, let's go over here, that's the meat we'll use. Just over about a kilo of meat. We'll use it to make meat buna. So we're cooking a few dishes together, so I'm going to concentrate on this one first. Lovely, so we'll simmer it for a couple of minutes. We put two large onions, and as you can see, a couple of 4 to 5 bay leaf, and cardamom and cinnamon, and a couple of cloves of garlic. Crushed, you can crush it or you can shred it. Same thing with ginger. Yes. Couple of teaspoon of oil. You can put tablespoon oil if you like, and a small tiny amount of salt, and keep on simmering for a couple of minutes, probably 4 or 5 minutes, and just like that what I'm doing. Okay. Put the lid on for a couple of minutes, leave it till it simmers. Alright, we're almost ready for the spice now. We're gonna add up spice. Curry powder is going in. 2 teaspoons of curry powder. Curry powder, 2 teaspoons, yeah. Zira powder. 2 teaspoons zira powder. Dhania powder. 1 teaspoon of dhania, coriander. Mix powder going in. 2.5 teaspoon of mixed curry powder. That's haldi powder. 1.5 teaspoon of haldi powder. 1.5. That's it. Now just what you need to do is mix them together. Mix them in oil in. And you have to make sure you leave it for a couple of minutes. So the spice, you have to burn the spice, so the raw smell of the spice disappears. Now we go back and wash the meat properly. Make sure you wash your meat properly. sorry, it's in on a just tip all the meat in there, and what you need to do is make sure you stir all the meat and the spice nicely evenly together. Make sure they're all well mixed in. You have to just shake it, if you have to do it, shake it, right? And then put the lid on. Put the lid going in there. So leave the lid on to cook on a slow gas for 40 to 45 minutes. 40 to 45 minutes of slow cooking. Just, you can see, simmering away now. So we're just going to put the lid on and leave it to cook for 40 to 45 minutes, slow gas. And then we'll come back. Right, here we cooked it for about 20 minutes now. As you can see, it's nicely looking like mellowing, and the meat starts to work all the magic in there, and slowly the meat will get tender and juicy. So we'll cook for another couple of more minutes. To get the right flavor, you have to cook it for about 30 45 minutes or so. Look at the flavor coming out there, you know. Now you can really taste it. It tastes fabulous, absolutely. I'm going to put the lid back on and wait till they finish. I'm going to show you the final. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is it. This is almost finished. Now we're going to put some little bit of coriander just to top it up. What we need to do is stir the coriander in. And because this is a bhuna, so bhuna tend to be dry curry, so we're going to keep it dry. There we are. And the heat of the curry will cook the coriander, so you don't have to stir it too much. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Our lovely homemade meat bhuna. Bhuna ghost. It's a type of dish you tend to order when you get to the restaurants. So, as you can see, it should hopefully taste lovely. Well, everyone, thank you so much for watching this video and all of my other videos. Please click like, subscribe, and make comment on those videos. And hopefully I will do another video soon. So watch out for the video, get the notification button clicked in, click the like and subscribe button, and That's about it. And thank you so much for your support on this channel. Over the years, everybody has given me so much support. So once again, thank you so much.